dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
Am 28. August 1963, auf den Treppen des Lincoln Memorials in Washington, D.C., Dr. King proclaimed his dream for America. 5 Jahre später, am 4. April 68, der Kugel eines Attentäters hat diesen großen Mann niedergestreckt. Aber am 21. Januar 2009, Barack Obama became the 44th president of the United States. Color finally came to the White House. Aber so, Freunde, brothers and sisters, glaube es oder nicht, as we speak in my home country, USA, Rassisten sind wieder unterwegs. Und lautstark im Radio, im Fernsehen, in Zeitungen, Politiker, Privatmenschen, Pastoren proklamieren, Obama ist ein Feind Amerikas, selber ein Rassist, der weiße Amerikaner hasst und ein Diener des islamistischen Terror. So weit ist es gekommen. Dr. King dreht sich im Grabe. Hier als Anfang, beim Anfang unseres zweiten Teils, haben wir einen Song ausgesucht, was Beyoncé sang bei der Inauguration of our president. Sam Cooke made it famous. Otis Redding sang it. Tonight, our sister number one here, Harriet Lewis, and our blue-eyed brother here, Daniel Stoyanov, are going to sing it for you. A change is going to come. Believe me, America needs that change. Also Germany. We all need it. We all need it. A change is going to come.
Ooh, you wind up knocking me
song, what a song, what a message.